What is EFT? EFT stands for Emotional Freedom Techniques. It's often also referred to as tapping because that describes the technique itself. Sometimes we even refer to it as a stress management or a relaxation skill because it does have that effect on certain parts in the brain. And often you might hear it referred to as psychological acupuncture, so a version of acupuncture that doesn't use any needles but still calms us down. So EFT or tapping uses a tapping process using two fingers on certain pressure points. Some of them are on the face and the top half of the body. We've now had decades of research behind EFT for things like stress, anxiety, worry, even things like pain, weight loss, phobias, and certainly the big things like post-traumatic stress disorder. So this tapping technique, to date, we know, affects certain parts of the brain that send out that stress response. Parts of the brain called the amygdala have a calming effect when tapping is done. If you can feel calmer about a problem you've used tapping on, you can think more clearly and then make better decisions. So we hope that you'll give tapping a go today. So what's the research and how does EFT actually work? What we understand to date is there is a certain part in the brain that sends out the stress response. It's often responsible for why we might not feel great. We might have an anger feeling, we might have an anxious or a worried feeling. We might even have more dramatic feelings too, like post-traumatic stress symptoms. And we know that that part of the brain responds when we do the tapping or the EFT technique. It appears to calm these parts of the brain, one of them being the amygdala. The hippocampus is another part of the brain that sits near the amygdala, that stress response center. And the hippocampus is often responsible for storing memories, and it will remind us sometimes of a similar event in our past. We now have over 100 published trials across 10 different countries, numerous journals. And we know that EFT has amazing responses across a range of different conditions. So we have evidence that's there to support it for decreasing phobias, for treating symptoms like post-traumatic stress disorder, for even things like weight loss and food cravings, as well as things like chronic pain and peak performance. All of those clinical trials have been run over the last 10 years and are now widely available for people to read the research and evidence behind them. We have trials that are coming out supporting its use for school students for things like exam anxiety, and the list is continuing. Depression is included in that list, and like I said, specific pain conditions like fibromyalgia. So the evidence base is building. We know there's a part of the brain that seems to be responding, and we've most recently had research that has come out and said EFT actually has the ability to turn off or deregulate up to 6 genes in our bodies that are responsible for the stress symptoms and syndrome. So we now know we have this tool that actually has a physiological effect on us. We know that cortisol, that stress hormone that's released when we're in that state, is actually downregulated as well with the EFT technique. I encourage you to go and read more around the EFT research. And the links to these are on our website. There's so much on offer that EFT can actually be useful for that I encourage you to explore them all. How to do the EFT or tapping technique. Typically, when we choose to use tapping, it's because there's something that's bothering us, perhaps something you want to change. In starting this technique, we always think about what it is that we want to change. It could be a feeling, it might be a thought, it could be a pattern of behaviour that you've noticed. Normally we ask ourselves, how do I feel about that? And we give it a rating out of 10. We call this the SUDS rating. SUDS stands for Subjective Units of Distress, and it's our personal rating of how we feel. We use a rating out of 10. So 10 represents the most amount of distress that you could feel about this situation, and 0 or a 1 would represent being completely calm and relaxed, e.g. you don't have any issue about it. So we give a rating out of 10 before we even start. That's how we know the tapping technique is having an effect on us. After we start by giving it a number, we then come to the first pressure point, and that's the one here on the side of the hand. And as we tap on the side of the hand, we say a setup statement. And that setup statement is comprised of two parts. The first part of the statement is our problem. So we state that often out loud, and we just acknowledge what it is that's happening for us. The second half of that statement is an acceptance of that problem. We're not accepting it's not going to change, but we're just accepting that's how we feel in this moment, and we're choosing to use the tapping technique to change that. As we say that statement, we tap on this pressure point on the side of the hand. So with two fingers, we just tap. The statement might go something like this. Even though I have this anger, I accept myself anyway. So you can see the two halves of that statement, the problem and the acceptance. And we say our statement three times while we tap on the side of the hand, just so we really tune into what the problem is. So I'll continue with the anger example. So even though I have this anger, I completely accept myself anyway. Even though I have this angry feeling, I accept myself. Even though I have this anger, I accept myself anyway. So that's the start of the technique. The second part is to go through each of the pressure points, and I'll walk you through these now. The first one is the start of the eyebrow. You may or may not feel anything necessarily, but tapping again with two fingers. And as we tap there, we say a short version of that setup statement from here. So in this case, it might be my anger. The second point is the side of the eye. So you'll often feel it dips in there, and we tap there. And again, we say that short word, this anger. The next one is under the eye, and it will be on that eye bone. This anger. The next one is directly under the nose. Again, I would say my anger. The next one is called the chin point, although it is just under the lips there where the chin dips in, and we would say this anger. The next point is the collarbone point, and it is normally an inch or two under the end of your collarbone. So there is one on each side, and you can choose which one to tap on there. This anger. The next point is directly under the arm. So you might find it's about four fingers underneath the armpit. This anger. And the very last point is the center of your head. So tapping with those two fingers there. This anger. We would take a deep breath at this point. And that's what we call one round of tapping. We now ask you to think of that number out of 10 again. Think what it was that you were tapping on. How do you feel about it now? Because it's a subjective rating, you might find that a different number just comes to mind. You might find it's the same. And it's an opportunity to know, where am I at with that feeling? You might be able to even feel it in your body. If it's the same feeling and you need to keep tapping to reduce it, you would start back at your eyebrow. Keep going with the same feeling and the same words. If you found a different feeling comes to mind when you're checking in, and it's different to what you started with, perhaps it's not anger anymore, it may be, I feel resentment. We would ask you to come back and start that one again with a new setup statement using the new feeling and continue through the points. So you may find two or three rounds of tapping is all you need to reduce that feeling. It is subjective. You might find yourself feeling just more calm, more relaxed. You might be able to think just a little bit more clearly about that. If you find other things come to mind as you're tapping, we encourage you to try some of the other techniques that are in our series. So I'd like you to think about a recent time in your life that you felt stressed. There could be one just the other day, maybe it was a week or so ago. I want you to think about that for a moment now, just to be able to tune into that feeling. It could be something you feel physiologically in your body. Where would you normally feel stress? It could be that you can just relate to that time a little while ago when you had that feeling. And I'd like you to give it a number out of 10 now. 10 would be the highest amount of stress, and 0 would be, I don't feel stressed at all, I'm completely calm and relaxed. So that SUDS rating out of 10, what would that be at the moment when you think about that recent time? We're going to do some tapping now around that stressful time that you had, and we'll start with our setup statement. I'll use generic words, but if you have specific words that describe it, please use those yourself. If you can feel the stress feeling now in your body, also tune in to where that is. Keep that in mind as we tap. So let's start with the side of the hand. Even though I had this recent time in my life where I felt really stressed, I completely accept myself. Even though I had this recent time of stress, and I can still feel it now, I accept myself anyway. Even though I had this time in my life where I felt a lot of stress, I accept myself, but I'm choosing to do something about it. And now we'll come to our first point and say a shortened version of that. Stressed. I felt so stressed. This stress. My feeling of stress. This stress in my body, I can still feel this stress. This stress in my body, that time when I felt stressed. I'll ask you to take a deep breath at this point. And as you do that, if you can feel where that was in your body, tune into that now. Or just think about that recent time where you did feel stress and give it a number out of 10 now after just one round of tapping. What has happened with that number? Has it increased? Has it decreased? Has it stayed the same? Wherever it is, that's your starting point from here. But we'll come back to our eyebrow point and continue with those words. This stress. My stress. This stress I felt, stress in my body, stress in my mind, that stressful time, I felt so much stress. I felt so stressed. Take a deep breath in, and again, tune in, think about that recent time. Feel it in your body now. Where would you give it out of 10 now after two rounds of tapping? Is it starting to shift a little bit? If you find a different feeling comes to mind, remember you can stop and start and set up that feeling again with the side of the hand and those three statements. But let's do one more round just on stress and allowing it to let go. And you can continue with this after the video. So back to our eyebrow. This stress I felt, I'm choosing to let it go. This stress I still have is beginning to decrease. My stress from that day, all of this stress is leaving me. My stress is dropping. I'm feeling calmer. Deep breath in and checking where that stress is at now. If you're finding it's down quite low, a naught or a one when you think about that time in your life, fantastic. If not, you know you can continue tapping. You can use the word stress or any other description, any feeling in your body, anything that describes what your experience was, and continue tapping until that number out of 10 reaches quite a low point. you know you then will be able to think more clearly and make different decisions.